Hello, this is Greg with Austin Boats and Motors, and I'm here to show you a brand new 2019 Tige RZX2. This is a beautiful boat. It's got all kinds of upgrades as far as the accents and the metal flakes. It's got the upgrade to Cool Touch Vinyl. And Cool Touch Vinyl is a vinyl that no matter what sun is on it, it's actually a lot cooler than regular vinyl, and it dissipates heat very quickly. So you can be right in the direct sun and it's not going to burn you. That's a really nice upgrade. It's also got some of the upgrades like the transform seat we'll see in a second. And it's got a battery charger installed on it as well. It's going to have the tower accent lighting. It's going to have the black surf bimini top with the boot. The RGB package, which allows the interior and tower lights to change to any color with the remote. It's going to have two underwater transom lights and the ICE Rev 10 Tower of Power system. So you can see those two Rev 10s up top there on that E2 tower. And then the ICE Audio Transom Display remote. We'll see that in a second on the back as well. So this boat's going to come with the Tige Armor mooring cover. And it's going to have the Tige Pro Driver mirror installed on it as well. Of course, you're going to see the Z-Cline seat with the bolster when we go and check it out here in a little bit. And this Tige also comes with the plug-and-play ready two rear bags. So, and the fresh air exhaust for safety, as well as makes that boat a lot quieter out there. So, and then of course you saw the E2 swivel racks that are on the tower as well. They can hold surfboards or wakeboards for you. If you look underneath, it's going to be sitting on a Boatmate custom trailer with high-end wheels and tires. And it is color matched to the boat. I like this one because these RZX2s sit up a little bit higher and they allow all the ballast to be underneath the floor. And on this boat, there's 2,800 pounds of under-the-floor ballast. But because it sits higher, that ladder on the front there, those steps on the front of this Boatmate trailer, are really nice when launching the boat. So you're going to notice that this boat does have a swing tongue. It also has a spare. And that spare is also just like the other ribs as well, so it is a high-end spare. Now let's go take a look at the back of the boat, and we can look at the TAPS 3 system. Okay, so when we look at the back of this boat, you're going to notice there's a lot of stuff going on back here. Over just to the left and underneath the platform, you're going to see one of the transom lights that is for underwater, and that is a great one. Now these plates, starting with the one on the left, going to the one in the middle, right behind the fresh air exhaust, and then also the one on the right. That is the TAPS 3 system. And you'll notice that those plates are slightly bent, and they're bent at an angle. What that does is that's going to allow this boat to be put into a yaw, as well as helping list the boat. So this TAPS 3 system, because it can be varied, is a truly adjustable surf system. A lot of other systems out there are either engaged or not engaged. You actually have a dial of 10 surf settings and 8 tap settings that you can scroll through to change the size and shape of your wave on this boat. Now we go back to the center object right there, that big pipe that comes out and then points down. That thing is our fresh air exhaust. That is going to push the exhaust deeper in the water and allow for the boat to, the exhaust will dissipate, but it also allows for the boat to be a lot more silent with that exhaust going deep into the water like that. So it has multiple effects, which is really nice. And then if you look down underneath that, just past the rudder, there is the oversized four-blade prop. And so they've got a large prop that they're pushing on this boat. It does have the 2-1 gear ratio and the 400 Raptor engine in it. And it is a beast. As we come up a little bit right here, you'll notice that large platform area with a nice grab handle. And then up a little higher, we're going to zero in here a little closer on that transom remote. All right, here we are with the transom remote. And you're going to notice a couple of cool things on there, which is on the right-hand side of this remote, it has sectors of areas in the boat. So you have your bow speakers, your aft speakers, your tower speakers, and your sub. You can control those volumes independently, depending on what you'd like to increase for your volume. In addition, you know, you've got your audio controls to the left side over there, as well as the source right there in the center. So lots of options here. When you look at this back area, you notice that there is a nice little area to sit, and there's stainless steel cup holders on either side. There's four here on the back area for when you're wanting to entertain and hang out back here on the back of the boat. Now let's crawl on inside this guy and check out some more. Actually, I wanted to show one last thing before we did get inside. That is going to be the backup camera, or rear view camera, that is going to be right there in the rub rail mounted. And it's going to give you excellent visibility back here for anything close down to the water, as well as what's directly behind you. And that includes your wake surfer. So with the big 10.5-inch screen that we have up here for the driver, he can actually utilize that to really get some great visibility back here without having to turn around. Now we'll crawl into the boat. So when you look directly down as you get in the back of the boat over here, looking towards the boat from the platform, you're going to notice that we've got some great little compartments here on top of this back area where you can sit, but you can also store wet items. This is a great spot for ropes. It's a great spot for wetsuit tops or things that you know that are going to be wet when you go to put them out, because it does have a drain down at the bottom. And of course, you got an identical one over here on this side as well. And here in the middle, this is unique to the RZX2, is that it does have the pull-up pull there for pulling slalom skiers or for pulling tubes down low, so you don't put too much torque on your tower. So that is kind of a nice option right there. This center cushion right here is it's a filler cushion. And it is designed to fill in the hole, which is the step through. And you can see that right there. So this is a great way to keep your upholstery nice, is to have this step through area where everybody walks through, as opposed to walking across your upholstery to get inside the boat. And we take a look at the boat from the back here. There is some great seating. It comes all the way around, stretches, and goes all the way across the back of the boat and back up to the driver. There are two rear-facing seats that we're going to flip up here in a second, you'll see. And then, of course, that's the Z-Cline captain's chair. That thing is amazing. If we look up here a little higher, you're going to notice the Rev-10s that are on there, as well as the swivel racks. And all put up in the boot over there is the Surf Bimini top, and that's going to have pockets on top for the surfboards. And if you look to the very front, you'll notice there is a bow filler cushion up there as well, and that cushion is to make that into a playpen. But another unique thing for the RZX2 over the RZX3 is that it does have a walk-through nose, so you can actually sit up there with your legs on the ground and not have to do the Indian style thing or feet in front of you necessarily if you don't want to. So it does offer some nice options in this boat. Now let's get in and check out some more storage and other options. Here we are kind of looking backwards just so you can get a perspective of the back of the boat. And there is the back seat going all the way across. Now let's take a look at some of the storage back there. Alright, now we see the compartments open here. And you'll notice that this center seat comes out, and the engine compartment is massive. They really did it right on this. The mechanics love the space and the ability to get to that engine. Of course, here's the other storage on this side. Let's get a little closer to this thing. This is the 400 Raptor 2-to-1. It does have a closed cooling system, which is typically extra for most boats. That comes as a standard option on all the Tigers. And you can see this massive 6.2 liter engine is ready to go. This thing is powerful. and we'll push this giant boat through the water with no problems whatsoever. Here is our storage compartment on the side here, and what you're seeing right there is our plug and play for the bags that you can get with this boat. So I highly encourage it because more is always better. But once again, this does have 2,800 pounds of ballast under the floor, and then you can add an additional two bags back here to make it even more. So, and you'll notice the same things. There's plugs and plays on the back wall over there of this one as well. All right, let's take a better look at the rest of the boat. All right, so here's a look from the side view. We're looking at the starboard side, or driver's side right now. And I wanted to show you the insets that they have for the speakers, for the grab handles, for the stainless steel cup holders, as well as just the extensive stitching and detail to all of this upholstery. It is gorgeous. I mean, they really do a lot to make this thing stand out. And it is beautiful. So now there is some storage underneath here, as well as a rear-facing seat, and I'm going to show that to you now. Okay, here you see that rear seat deployed, and it essentially just folds up from right there to face backwards behind the driver's seat right here, and it allows someone sitting on this side over here to actually just face backwards. So it's a rear face seating. And then we'll show you what's underneath here. So these are hinged, and you've got storage underneath here because all your ballast is under the floor. Now, if we also look back over here from this side, you're going to notice the same detail, the same insets where the large speakers are. And we continue down through here. There's another rear-facing seat right there. There's some additional storage back there behind it. And then another inset with another speaker, all the way up here to the rear-facing passenger seat and the glove box area. So now let's take a look at some of the storage on this side. Here's the storage under that seat over here. And all the way up here to this rear-facing seat. And the rear-facing seats, very easy to deploy. Pull straight up. Now you're facing, and if you look in the back here, there's just that one knob. You pull that knob out, and the seat drops back down with the help of your hand. There you go. And lastly, we've got lots of storage up underneath here. You're going to see, first off, a really neat vanity mirror. And then when we look down here a little further, this boat comes from the factory with a Yeti soft-sided bag. You're going to see some of the other items that are included in this boat. It does have two Wake Maker extra ballast bags for the rear. And then if you look underneath here, you can see the massive Wet Sounds amps that power all the stereo in this boat. So, beautiful setup in here. Lots of space. Now, one of the cool things I like about this boat, when you get over here to the glove box, so you're getting ready to take this boat out, you got your battery switch off, you don't have to go digging around behind you in the back compartment. It's right here, right in the glove box, and ready to go. So, really like the location of the battery switch on this boat. Now, this boat also has a trash can. That trash can is located right here, so that you don't have to clutter up the floor. You can just put your trash right there and empty it when you're done. We did discuss how this boat has the walkthrough. You can kind of notice that right here. And I will remove this so you can see what it looks like without it. So here it is without it. I'll back up a little bit so you can truly see how you can really sit now with your feet down and be tons more comfortable. Now as we walk forward here, this front cushion, it's a neat little spot right up here for cooler. So you got a area that can hold whatever you like to drink in there with a drain down at the bottom. And we're gonna get over here and check out the storage right here. This is also where the battery charger is located. You're going to notice it's going to be right there. And it also gives you access to that same compartment with your amps and everything in it. And then we have that same kind of storage over here on the backside of the helm. There, a little extra storage there. So when we come back to the nose of the rear of the boat, now we're going to check out this large Z-Cline chair. Probably the most comfortable inboard seat captain's chair I've ever sat in. It's got the ability to slide forward, backward, swivel, as well as the back reclines. And then you've got the bolster seat right here that you can shove up if you want to sit a little higher. But super, super comfortable seat. So we're going to swing around over here. This boat has not been wired yet, I don't believe, so we're not going to be able to turn on the screen to see it today, but there is a picture or a view of that screen, 10.5-inch, clear touchscreen by Tige. Runs everything. It's amazing. It also shows you what's behind you there in your rearview camera. But that's not the only truly amazing thing up here in the front. The ISOC awesome steering wheel controls right here are amazing. They are truly awesome. Like, they're so intuitive. I got used to them like within the first 10 minutes and was using them to control most features on the boat. You've got over here to the left, you've got the billeted phone holder and a little sleeve up above it so you can put something there. One of the things that you're going to notice about this, though, is look how low that dash is. That dash is really, really low when sitting in the seat. And that's something that Tige went out of their way to try to do, is to make the dash on these boats really low so you have incredible visibility. Lots of other boats out there, man, they're just filling their dash with so much stuff that you really literally have to sit on the bolster the whole time just to be able to see out the front. But not this boat. Now, underneath the steering wheel, you'll notice there is a sub. There's a beautiful wet sound sub. And this boat, man, the sound system in this thing is incredible. So one of the things that I wanted to show people that question comes up every now and then is, what happens if your screen goes out? How can you still operate the boat safely? Well, there's a couple of different things. Basically, your screen doesn't control the motor, so you can actually operate the throttle and the steering wheel and utilize the boat without your screen. It does operate some components that are pretty important, like your bilge pump, your ballast pump, empty. Your navigation lights if it's at nighttime. And the neat thing about that is that underneath this seat over here, and I'll pull it out so we can see. Underneath here on this side of the wall, you're going to notice a bank of switches. Those are your manual switches for your ballast empty, your bilge pump, your blower, and your nav lights. All the essential items that you're going to need to operate this boat if your screen goes out. So redundancy on this boat is awesome. You know, the chances of the screen going out are really nil. We're working with the Murphy screen that is a really well built screen used in the restaurant industry for many years. They take lots of abuse, lots of longevity, but they're great. So this has been the 2019 Tige RZX2. You've been watching Greg with Austin Boats and Motors, and you can find us off of Highway 620 in Lakeway, or look us up at austinboats.com. Come check us out.